Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn the topic immune systems in the body. What is meant by immune? Immune means giving resistance against diseases. Resistance against diseases. Immune system in the body. The human immune system consists of lymphoid organs. See that, which are the human lymphoid organs, tissues, cells, and soluble molecule like antibodies. The human immune system consists of lymphoid organs, tissues, cells, and soluble molecules like antibodies. The human immune system consists of lymphoid organs, tissues, cells, and soluble molecules like antibodies. As you have read, immune system is unique in the sense that it recognizes foreign antigens only. As you have already known, immune system is very unique in the sense that it recognizes foreign antigens only. Foreign antigens. See, responds to these and remembers them also. Foreign antigens. It responds to this foreign antigen and it is remembering that also. The immune system also plays an important role in allergic reactions, autoimmune disease, and organ transplantation. The immune system also plays an important role in allergic reactions, autoimmune disease, and organ transplantation. Autoimmune disease and organ transplantation. Autoimmune disease, that already we had learned that the body lose the capacity because of genetic disorders or other not knowing reasons. Body losing the capacity to distinguish self and foreign. So autoimmune disease. Organ transplantation means organ is transplanting. Now heart transplantation, liver transplantation, like kidney transplantation, like that you may be had. So that is. So lymphoid organs, these are the organs where origin or maturation and proliferation of lymphocytes occur. These are the organs where origin and or maturation and proliferation of lymphocytes occur. Origin of lymphocytes occur, maturation of lymphocytes occur, and multiplication of lymphocytes occur in this organ. These are the organs where origin and or maturation and proliferation of lymphocytes occur. The primary lymphoid organs are bone marrow and thymus. The primary lymphoid organs are bone marrow and thymus only. Primary lymphoid organs are bone marrow and thymus. Bone marrow and thymus, where immune lymphocytes differentiate, where immune lymphocytes are differentiate into antigen sensitive lymphocytes. So in these two region only, it is differentiate into antigen sensitive. First, it should be sense which antigen it is. According to that only antibody is produced. So the primary lymphoid organs are bone marrow and the thymus, where immune lymphocytes differentiate into antigen sensitive lymphocytes. After maturation, the lymphocytes migrated to secondary lymphoid organs like spleen, lymph nodes, tonsils, phase patches of small intestine and appendix. After maturation, the lymphocytes migrated to secondary lymphoid organs like spleen, lymph nodes, tonsils, phase patches of small intestine and appendix. Diagram also shown here that lymphatic vessel, thymus, lymph nodes, etc. The secondary lymphoid organ provides the sites of interaction of lymphocytes with the antigen. Interaction of lymphocytes with the antigen, which is then proliferated to become effector cells, which is then proliferated to become effector cells. The location of various lymphoid organs in human body is shown in 8.5 only. Lymph nodes, the solar structure seen here, lymph nodes, thymus, lymphatic vessels. So now we are learning about the immune systems in the body. Already told that consists of lymphoid organs, tissues, cells, and soluble molecule like antibodies. Lymphoid organs only we are learning now. These are the organs where origin and or maturation and proliferation of lymphocytes occur. The primary lymphoid organs are bone marrow and thymus, where immature lymphocytes differentiate into antigen sensitive lymphocytes. After maturation, the lymphocytes migrated to secondary lymphoid organs like spleen, lymph nodes, tonsils, phase patches, so small intestine and appendix. The secondary lymphoid organs provide the sites of interaction of lymphocytes with the antigen, which then proliferate. Proliferate means multiplying in number to become effector cells. The location of various lymphoid organs in the human body is shown in figure 8.5. The bone marrow is the main lymphoid organ. The bone marrow is the main lymphoid organ where all blood cells including lymphocytes are produced. Inside the bone marrow only, that is the main lymphoid organ, bone marrow. The in between the bone space is there, that is called the bone marrow, inside the bone. So bone marrow is the main lymphoid organ where all blood cells, RBC, WBC, platelets, all are producing there only, including lymphocytes are produced. The thymus is a lobed organ located near the heart. Location of thymus is that. Thymus is a lobe, it is not shown here. Position only shown here. Lobed organ only. Thymus is a lobed organ located near the heart and beneath the breastbone only. So location of thymus, it is a lobed organ located near the heart and beneath the breastbone. The thymus is quite large at the time of birth because when children are there, they are having less immunity. So more immunity should be there to provide more immunity. At childhood time, this thymus is a large gland. Thymus is a large gland. After maturity, it becomes short in size only because after attaining maturity, we ourselves are having some response or resistance against the diseases. So thymus is quite large at the time of birth, but it keeps reducing in size with age. And by the time puberty is attained, it reduces to a very small size only. Very small size only. Puberty means adulthood. By the time of attained, it reduces to very small size. Both the bone marrow and thymus provide micro environment for the development and maturation of T lymphocytes. Both the bone marrow and thymus provide micro environment for the development and maturation of T lymphocytes. The spleen is a large bean-shaped organ. It mainly contains lymphocytes and phagocytes. The spleen is a large bean-shaped organ. It mainly contains lymphocytes and phagocytes. It acts as a filter of the blood by trapping blood-borne microorganisms. Blood is filtering the spleen by trapping blood-borne microorganisms are trapping there. So spleen is an important organ. It is a large bean-shaped organ. It mainly contains lymphocytes and phagocytes. Both of them are giving resistance against the disease. These lymphocytes and phagocytes. It acts as a filter of the blood by trapping blood-borne microorganisms. Spleen also has a large reservoir of erythrocytes. Spleen also has a large reservoir of erythrocytes. Erythrocytes means RBC. It is storing the RBC inside. The lymph nodes are small solid structures. Lymph nodes. These are the lymph nodes. See here the lymph nodes. Blue color is given here. Here you can see. So lymph nodes are small solid structure located at different points along the lymphatic system only. The lymph nodes are small solid structures located at different points along the lymphatic system only. So here already you can blue color dot seeing, that is the lymph nodes. Lymph nodes serve to trap the microorganism or other antigens which happen to get into the lymph and tissue fluid only. Lymph nodes serve to trap the microorganism or other antigens which happen to get into the lymph and tissue fluid. Antigen trapped in the lymph nodes are responsible for the activation of lymphocytes present there and cause the immune response. So lymph nodes serve to trap the microorganism or other antigens which happen to get into the lymph and tissue fluid. Antigens trapped in the lymph nodes are responsible for the activation of lymphocytes present there and cause the immune response. There is lymphoid tissue also located within the lining of the major tract, that is respiratory, digestive, urogenital tract called the mucosal associated lymphoid tissue or mold. Mucosa. Mucosa means layers of mucus is there. This there is a lymphoid tissue also located within the lining of the major tract. Which are the major tract in our body? Respiratory. Cough is there, no? So mucus is there. Digestive peristalsis is occurring through the mucus only. And urogenital tract also mucus is there. So this is called mucosal associated lymphoid tissue. Short form it is called MALT. It constitutes about 50% of the lymphoid tissue in human body. About full human body, 50% is constituting by this mucosal associated lymphoid tissue, that is MALT only, because four main components of our body, that three: respiratory, digestive and urogenital tract. All this tract is lined by mucus lining only. It is lined by mucus lining, that is the lymphoid tissue. So the lymphoid tissue associated with the mucus is called the mucosal associated lymphoid tissue. It constitutes about 50% of the lymphoid tissue in human body. So now we are learning about the immune systems in the body: lymphoid organ, tissues, cells, or soluble molecule like antibodies. That the lymphoid organ, we had learned that primary lymphoid organ is bone marrow and thymus. Immature lymphocytes differentiate and it become antigen sensitive inside this bone marrow and the thymus. After maturation, lymphocytes migrate to secondary lymphoid organs like spleen only. After maturation only, forming in bone marrow and thymus. After maturation and after it got the sensation, it migrates to other organs like spleen, lymph nodes, stone cells, phage, patches of small intestine and appendix. The secondary lymphoid organ provide the sites of interaction of lymphocytes with the antigen, which then proliferate or multiply in number to become effector cells. The location of various lymphoid organs in the human body is shown in figure 8.5. The bone marrow is the main lymphoid organ where all blood cells including lymphocytes are produced. The thymus is a lobed organ located near the heart and beneath the breastbone. The thymus is quite large at the time of birth, but it keeps reducing in size with age, and by the time puberty is attained, it reduces to a very small size. Both the bone marrow and thymus provide a micro environment for the development and maturation of T lymphocytes. The spleen is a large bean-shaped organ. It mainly contains lymphocytes and phagocytes. It acts as a filter of the blood by trapping blood-borne microorganisms or filtering there by the spleen. Spleen also has a large reservoir of erythrocytes, RBC, also storing inside the spleen. So lymph nodes, now we are coming to the lymph nodes. Lymph nodes are small solid structures located at different points along the lymphatic system. Lymph nodes serve to trap the microorganism or other antigen which happens to get into the lymph and tissue fluid. Antigen trapped in the lymph nodes are responsible for the activation of lymphocytes present there and cause the immune response. There is lymphoid tissue also located within the lining of the major tracts in our body. The major tube or tract in our body, tract means tube only, respiratory tube, digestive tube and urogenital tract. As you knowing that all the three ducts are covered with the mucus lining of lymphoid tissue, the lymphoid tissue associated with the mucus is called the mucus associated lymphoid tissue. It constitutes about 50% of the lymphoid tissue of the body. All remaining are 50% only. These three, that is mucus associated lymphoid tissue, is 50% only. Now we are going to learn another disease, that is AIDS. AIDS, about AIDS, everybody knowing. What is the full form of AIDS? Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. The word AIDS stands for acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. This means deficiency of immune system acquired during the lifetime of an individual, indicating that it is not a congenital disease. This means deficiency of immune system. Actually, the person which are occupied by the, which is the virus causing the AIDS? Virus causing the AIDS is human immunodeficiency virus, that is HIV, human immunodeficiency. So in the name itself, you understood that by the attack of this virus, immunity is losing. Immunity is losing. Actually, this person is not dying because of this virus. When this virus is entering to the body, actually this person is losing the immunity. So by any germs which first comes into the body, by that the person can be died. This means deficiency of immune system acquired during the lifetime of an individual, indicating that it is not a congenital disease. Syndrome means a group of symptoms. Only. Syndromes means group of symptoms. AIDS was first reported in 1981. And in the last 25 years or so, it has spread all over the world, killing more than 25 million persons. AIDS was first reported in 1981. And in the last 25 years or so, it has spread all over the world, killing more than 25 million persons, like this coronavirus. AIDS is caused by the human immunodeficiency virus, a member of group of virus called retrovirus. This immunodeficiency virus belongs to the group of virus retrovirus, which have an envelope enclosing the RNA genome. RNA is the genetic material of retrovirus, which have an envelope. One protein outer coating is also there. In that genetic material is RNA. Transmission of HIV infection generally occurs by sexual contact with infected person. Transmission of HIV infection generally occurs by sexual contact with infected person. Sexual contact with the infected person by transfusion of contaminated blood and blood products by sharing infected needles. This transmission is important only. Sexual contact with the infected person by transfusion of contaminated blood and blood products by sharing infected needles, as in the case of intravenous drug. Intravenous means injecting into the vein. Drugs are injecting into the vein. Abuses and from infected mother to her child through placenta. If mother is infected during her pregnancy through the placenta, it can be affected the child also, embryos. So these are the four reasons for the transmission of HIV infection. One time, read faster. Transmission of HIV. Slide I will show afterwards. Four reasons are there. It can be asked also, and you must be know that what are the reasons of transmission and why it is transmitting. That all you should be know also. Understood? So what are the reasons? Sexual contact with the infected person, sexual contact with infected person by transfusion of contaminated blood and blood products, by sharing infected needles, as in the case of intravenous drug abusers, and from infected mother to her child through placenta. So people who are at a high risk of getting this infection includes individuals who have multiple sexual partners, who can be committed fast. The people who are at a high risk of getting this infection includes individuals who have multiple partners or multiple sexual partners, drug addict who take a drug intravenously, individuals who require repeated blood transfusion, multiple sexual partners, drug addicts who take drugs intravenously, individuals who require repeated blood transfusion, and children born to an HIV infected mother. This person can be more suspected for the AIDS. Now in the context of coronavirus, one who are not wearing the mask, doctors and other medical staffs who are coming frequently with the coronavirus are more suspected to come. Like that, the multiple sexual partners, drug addicts who take drugs intravenously, individuals who require repeated blood transfusion, children born to an HIV infected mother, these all person can be having more risk. Do you know when do people need a repeated blood transfusion? Find out and make a list of such a condition. Repeated blood transfusion is doing in blood cancer, operations, and any poison drink that time only. Especially in blood cancer, repeated blood transfusion is occurring. It is important to note that HIV or AIDS is not spread by mere touch or physical contact. Like this touching, then it is not spreading. It is spread only through body fluids only. It only spread through body fluid by blood, like that only, body fluid. It is hence imperative for the physical and psychological well-being that the HIV/AIDS infected persons are not isolated from family. Because by simple touching, it is not spreading from one person to another and from society also. There is always a time lag between the infection and appearance of AIDS only. It takes time. Like coronavirus, it is not appearing faster. 14 days it is taking for coronavirus. It is taking more than that. There is a lag. There is a lag between the period of infection and appearance of AIDS symptoms. This period may vary from few months to many years. It can be usually 5 to 10 years. HIV virus entering into the body after 5 to 10 years only may be the person showing the symptoms of that disease. These type of persons are so dangerous. So we are not doubting their health also. We are not knowing that they are infected by HIV. From this type of person only, more randomly, it can be passed from one person to another. After getting into the body of the person, the virus enters into macrophages, where RNA genome of the virus replicates to form viral DNA with the help of the enzyme reverse transcriptase. What is this doing? That one, see that after getting into the body of the person, the virus enters into macrophages. This HIV virus, where its genetic material is RNA only. RNA genome of the virus replicated to form viral DNA with the help of the enzyme reverse transcriptase. Usually it is having RNA as the genetic material. From this RNA to form viral DNA. Genetic material is converted into DNA by reverse transcriptase. From DNA to RNA forming, then transcriptase is used. So this is the reverse unknown. RNA to DNA, so reverse transcriptase. The viral DNA gets incorporated into host cell's DNA. Now viral DNA is there. Viral DNA formed from viral RNA. So this viral DNA gets incorporated into host cell's DNA. Host cell means human being only. So our genetic material is DNA only, host cells. That DNA. Now both the DNA combine and direct the infected cells to produce virus particle. Understood? So first entering into the person, then it has the genetic, this virus is having the genetic material, retrovirus only. So genetic material is RNA only. From that RNA, it multiply and form DNA using the enzyme reverse transcriptase. Then this viral DNA associated with the human cell's DNA, that is natural DNA of the human cell, and direct the infected cells to produce virus particles. The macrophages continue to produce virus. Virus particle produced means it produce virus. So macrophages continue to produce virus, and in this way acts like a HIV factory only. And that cell will be act as HIV factory, means producing the virus only. Because already it produced the viral material, now it is having all the material required for the production of HIV virus. So actually the macrophages continue to produce virus, and in this way acts like a HIV factory. Simultaneously, HIV enter into helper T lymphocytes, replicates and produce progeny viruses. Okay. Simultaneously, HIV enters into the helper T lymphocytes, replicates and produce progeny viruses. The progeny viruses released in the blood attack the other helper T lymphocytes. Okay. The progeny virus released in the blood attack other helper T lymphocytes. This is repeated, leading to a progressive decrease in the number of helper T lymphocytes. In the body of the infected person. During this period, the person suffers from bouts of fever, diarrhea, weightiness. These are the symptoms. Suffers from bouts of fever, diarrhea, weightiness. Due to decrease in the number of helper T lymphocytes, helper T lymphocytes is associated with the immunoresistance only. So these helper T cells are decreasing. this one virus is killing this helper T cells, as a result persons are suffering from infections only, because persistence is losing by the less number of T lymphocytes. Due to the decrease in the number of helper T lymphocytes, the person starts suffering from infection that could have been otherwise overcome, such as those due to bacteria, especially mycobacteria, viruses, fungi, and even parasites like toxoplasma. Mycobacteria, viruses, and fungi, and even parasites like toxoplasma. The patient becomes so immunodeficient. The patient becomes so immunodeficient that he or she is unable to protect himself or herself against this infection. A widely used diagnostic test for AIDS is enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. A widely used diagnostic test for AIDS is enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. Treatment of AIDS with antiretroviral drugs is only partially effective. Antiretrovirus only causing this disease. So the medicine is antiretroviral drugs only, but it is partially effective. They can only prolong the life of the patient, but they cannot prevent death. Death is sure if AIDS is affected, but to prolong the life, the lifespan can be increased. They can only prolong the life of the patient, but they cannot prevent death, which is inevitable. So the person starts suffering from infection because of the decreasing number of T lymphocytes. Can be overcome, such as those due to bacteria, especially mycobacteria, viruses, fungi, and even parasites like toxoplasma. This resistance lost means any germs can be attacked from the atmosphere or the surrounding. But understood? We all are saving because of our resistance only. Otherwise, how many germs are there in the atmosphere and the surrounding surface? We all are saved from that because of our resistance against a disease only. So when resistance losing, any organism like a mycobacterium, viruses, fungi, even parasites also can be attacked. The patient becomes so immunodeficient that he or she is unable to protect himself or herself against these infections. A widely used diagnostic test for AIDS is enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. Treatment of AIDS with an antiretroviral drugs is only partially effective. They can only prolong the life of the patient but cannot prevent the death, which is inevitable. Now, how we can prevent the AIDS? As AIDS has no cure, no medicine is there. Already told that death is sure. Prevention is the best option. Moreover, HIV infection more often spreads due to conscious behavior patterns only. Our consciousness is there, then we can save from this AIDS only. Consciously we are doing, injecting the drug and sex with multiple partner. This all we can avoid at present only. And it's not something that happened inadvertently. It is not accidentally happening like that, like a pneumonia or typhoid. That pneumonia or typhoid we cannot be avoided in such a way. Of course, infection in blood transfusion patients, newborns, etc. may take place due to poor monitoring. The only excuse may be ignorance, and it has been rightly said, don't die of ignorance. Don't die of ignorance. Of course, infection in blood transfusion patients, newborns from mother, may take place due to poor monitoring only. Not giving care, because of that it can be occur. Not because of the mistake of the individual. Health system, they are not giving poor monitoring, only giving by that. Otherwise, mother is not listening about their pregnancy in that situation. So only excuse may be ignorance, and it has been rightly said that don't die of ignorance. In our country, the National AIDS Control Organization, NAPCO, and other non-governmental organization, NGOs, are doing a lot to educate people about AIDS. Who has started, WHO has started a number of programs to prevent the spreading of HIV infection, making blood safe from HIV, ensuring the use of only disposable needles and syringes in public and private hospitals and clinics, pre-distribution of condoms, controlling drug abuse, advocating safe sex, and promoting regular checkup for HIV in susceptible populations are some statistics taken only. So which are the steps? Making blood safe from HIV, ensuring the use of only disposable needles and syringes in public and private hospitals and clinics, free distribution of condoms, controlling drug abuse, advocating safe sex and promoting regular checkups for HIV in susceptible populations are some such steps taken. Infection with HIV or having AIDS is something that should not be hidden. Infection with HIV or having AIDS is something that should not be hidden. Since then, the infection may spread to many more people. HIV, AIDS infected people need help and sympathy instead of being shunned by the society. And if the person also don't want to hide the disease, by hiding that with others, it can be spread from that person to other person. And we don't want to avoid them also by mere touching. It cannot be the situation where it can be spread already. We had learned that otherwise we are sitting along with them or talking with them like that. It cannot be transferred. So people need help and sympathy instead of being shunned by society. Unless society recognizes it as a problem to be dealt with in a collective manner, the chances of wider spread of the disease increase manifold. It is a malady that can only be tackled by the society and the medical fraternity acting together to prevent the spread of the disease. This is about the AIDS. Cancer also, even cancer will be there. Cancer we will be learned in another section only. So today we had learned about the AIDS and the lymphoid organs of our body. Two topics: AIDS, lymphoid organs of our body, lymphoid organs of our body also learned. Lymphoid organs. So lymphoid organ diagram one time see that. Lymph nodes. So blue color dots. Thymus. Near to the heart only, above the chest bone, lymphatic vessels. Afterwards, we had learned the AIDS, retrovirus, and how it is infected. This diagram I didn't show you. This diagram is the retrovirus, viral RNA code. This is RNA of the genetic material, and a protein coat is also there. Outer one coat is there. That is, outer coating is protein, and inside. RNA genetic material which is infecting the cell, animal cell. Viral DNA is introduced into the cell. Viral DNA is produced. The viral RNA is introducing into the cell. Viral DNA is produced by device transcriptase. This is the DNA. It is from RNA. It is converted into RNA. This animal cell only shown. Last month I have seen there. So cell of the animal. Viral DNA incorporate into host genome. Host having already DNA, so this viral DNA is entering into the host DNA and affecting. This is the associated one. New viruses are produced. A new virus can infect other cells. Infected cell can survive while viruses are being replicated and released. The viruses are replicating. See that inside. This is the diagram of cell only given. Outer lining is seen. This one is cell. So inside the cell it is multiplicating or replicating in number, but cell will be sustained like that only. So retrovirus entering, RNA only entering, but it is convert, multiply and converted into DNA using the enzyme reverse transcriptase and incorporating with the host DNA, and this is incorporated with the host DNA and the new viruses are produced, and afterwards new viruses is affecting the other cells. So understood it, sir.